on the young rapper's level. I do something different. So for me, the thing that I'm trying to put across is to, when you get to a certain age, it's really for like a Jay-Z, a LL Cool J, Will Smith, people in Hollywood, show them that, you know, you can't be selfish. People are getting married in Hollywood and getting broken up the next day. That's because they don't take time to communicate. So I'm there on MTV as a staple, a pillar of being a good man and with a good family that's working hard to keep it together. So in the midst of an entertainment industry where people are falling apart and things are going crazy, my prayer is that that God would uphold me, that I could be there for something that you could look at and want to embrace. Inspiration to the American dream, an inspiration to family, you know what I mean? So for me, I'd be happy if at the end of the day, you know, I don't want to be known for the beautiful house and the Rolls Royce and the indoor ball court. That has a place, and that definitely, that flash on MTV keeps you interested, but that interest would wane without the love that you see on that couch. The love when you see me and my wife at the end of the shows talking, the inspirational messages that come across on Twitter and that you saw me doing. I don't know how many people saw Run's house, the inspirational messages I do from the tub. So for me, I mean, that's kind of weird. I ain't gonna lie. Like, grown man with a BlackBerry in the tub with bubbles, sending out messages. But I did that because that's what I do without the bubbles. But I had to put the bubbles because you'd see me naked, and that wouldn't work. So back to the question. Before the bubble talk and the tub. So I'm unique. I'm the Reverend Run. I'm Run, my Adidas, Walk This Way, Tricky, to rock a rhyme, it's right on time, it's tricky. But I'm also the Rev with the swag, and I'm cool, and all that stuff mixed in one. But at the end of the day, you know, just my message is to inspire people to do the right thing without being preachy.
I think sometimes people they want you to be in one box or the other. And so,
right?
How do you balance spirituality and emceeing?
Very simple. You got the Rev and you got the Run. So it's like I'll go out. It's weird. I don't know if somebody might have saw the episode I'm hanging with Kid Rock. That doesn't seem likely for a guy trying to clean up his life. How is Kid Rock your homie? Well, he drinks Jim Beam, I don't. You know, at the end of the show, he goes to his bus, I go to my bus. We're close friends, but I don't judge him. I'm not a judgmental guy on, you know, people grow in their time. He's a very close friend of mine. So the Rev Run is not, the reason why people follow me on Twitter and I can send out these words of wisdom and you'll watch the show, because we all want structure in our life. But we don't want to be judged. That's the main thing. So I balance it by not being this overly religious guy. Even the tweets that I send out, they have inspirational messages, but they're not like, you don't follow Jesus, you're going to hell, and blah, blah, blah. You know, like, I'm not just coming at you at that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not coming at you at, like, you're in trouble if you don't do all the right things. And I'm not perfect. I don't claim to be perfect. I don't act like I'm holier than thou. But yet, you know, I don't just let things around me just slip and go to hell either. So there's a balance there between being on point and there's something that Kid Rock always says, we're here for a good time, not for a long time. So have fun, but don't let your life go to hell. Something like that.
Yeah. Yeah. So we have one more question.
I'm speaking for many people here, but...
You're speaking for many people?
Yes.
You sure?
I think so.
Okay.
So basically, what do I have to do to get a retweet on Twitter?
Ah! I retweeted somebody today, said I'm going to see Rev Run today. It's random for me. It's like you say something and I'm sitting there. It's like, Rev Run really rocked today at our school, might get a retweet. Rev Run sucked today, probably won't get a retweet. So the more Rev Run rocked and was really funny, entertaining, and helpful to me, you might get a chance to get retweeted. It's like anything else.
Okay, look for Alex Grimes today. I'm going to tweet something.
Okay, if it's good, if it's under 120 characters. Okay.
Alex Groves!
You might be able to get a Rev Run retweet.
So on a more serious note, though, I know it's been a while since Distortion came out.
Yes.
What other kind of projects do you have going on right now as far as like music, clothing?
My project has become Diggy and my family and my wife. I've been almost reduced to the manager of my family because after Run's house, everybody became an entrepreneur in my house, down to Russi. So everybody's got their own little businesses set up. Diggy signed to Atlantic Records, and my wife's on Home Shopping Network. Vanessa and Angela moved to Los Angeles, and they have pastry sneakers. So I'm like on my BlackBerry, not only tweeting, but like, okay, do this for Angela. Okay, Diggy just landed in L.A. Make sure there's a credit card down for incidentals. So I'm like, I've become kind of like Beyonce's parents. I'm like, I'm a manager of the creation of the characters that you saw at Run's house that are now entrepreneurs. So I'm dad.